Welcome to Sophia English Channel. Today the topic is Judith Wright. We are going to see about the biography of Judith Wright. We all know about Judith Wright. Yes, she is a Judith Wright. Judith Wright's full name is Judith Ondell Wright. Born May 31st, 1915 at Amadali, New South Wales in Australia. She died at June 25th, 2000 at Canberra. It is a Australian Capital Territory. Yes, she is a Australian poet. Judith Wright. We come across so many poems which was written by her. Okay, as an Australian poet, she is well known for her style. He born in the early 20th century, was a well-known Australian poet, and she has written a short story and conversationalist. She was also highly accomplished critic of Australian poetry. As a famous Australian poet whose verse thoroughly modern in idiom is noted for skillful technique. So it is a skillful technique of Judith Wright, writing with the idiomatic. She can use the idioms while she is writing the poem. She used to have a idioms. And when we see that Judith as a child, she spent most of her formative years in Brisbane and Sydney. She was the first child of Philip Wright and his first wife Ethel. So she born for his first wife, that is a Philip Wright. When she was still in the tender years of her life, Judith Wright went through frequent ill health of her mother. This was when she started writing poetry mainly to please her mother and bring her merriment, because she loves her mother very, very much. That is Ethel. She loves her mother. Judith is very, very always so touched with her mother, because she loves her mother very much. Judith was brought up in her family's sheep station until the death of her mother in 1927. Thereafter, she was put under the guidance of her grandmother, who also take care of her education. In the year 1929, at the age of 14, Judith Wright enrolled in New England Girls' School. During the age of 14, she enrolled her name in New England Girls' School. Her love for poetry enhanced in the school, as it gave her immense comfort and solace. This was when she decided to become a poet. Because of school days only, she started to write a poem, as well as she is fond of poetic lines, that is a style of poem. In 1934, Judith Wright gained admission in Sydney University, where she studied philosophy, history, psychology and English, without taking a degree. At the beginning of the World War II, the shortage of manpower brought Wright back to her father's station. This served as a turning point in her life, as she developed immense attachment to the land and its people. This love for people and land was visible in her works as well. In 1934, she got admitted in Sydney University, and without any degree, she studied all those things, that is a philosophy, history, psychology and English. In her poem, we can see these things, that is a philosophy, histories, can be seen in her poems. right in her 20s started becoming increasingly deaf because of her ill health. She becoming increasingly, that is, a deaf. In 1937 to 38, she traveled to Britain and Europe. Until 1944, she worked as a secretary, stenographer and clerk. From the year 1944 to 1948, she worked at the University of Queensland, St. Lucia, as a university station. In 1946, she made her debut in poetry with her first book, The Moving Image. And because of her career, Judith Wright met J.P. McKinney when she was 30 years old. Though the later and unorthodox philosopher was 23 years her senior, she was attracted to him. Wright moved to Mount Tamaroin, Queensland, along with J.P. McKinney in 1950. In the same year, the duo was blessed with a daughter, whom they named Meredith. Judith and McKinney got married in 1962. In 1966, McKinney departed for the heavenly abode and Wright moved to NSW town of Braidwood. After that, she lost McKinney. It becomes very, very sad to her. After that, meeting with J.P. McKinney and moving to Queensland proved beneficial to her career. She wrote most of her works in the mountains of southern Queensland only, because she loved the place, that is a Queensland. Her next move to Braidwood was with respect to her protest against the political policies of John Bexley Peterson, the Premier of Queensland. It was her that Wright composed her nature-based poetry. Apart from being a poetess, Wright produced a hackwork school plays for Australian Broadcasting Commission and children's book to earn her livelihood. She contributed so many children's book, and which is always have a live one, that is a livelihood in her works. And she dedicated most of her works to the children. Wright also lectured as a part-timer at various Australian universities. In 1975, all her addresses and speeches were collected in the Literary Criticism, Because I Was Invited. Around this time, she was selected as a foundation fellow of the Australian Academy of the Humanities and an emeritus professor of lecturer board of the Arts Council of Australia. Sometime later, she wrote her own memory of a time, covering her life until 1960s, which was published in 2000. And when we see her writing style, her work is noted for a keen focus on the Australian environment, which began to gain a prominence in Australian art in the years following World War II. She deals with the relationship between settlers, indigenous Australians and the bush, among other themes. Judith Wright aesthetically centers on the relationship between a mankind and the environment, which she views as a catalyst for poetic creation. Her images characteristically draw from the Australian flora and fauna, yet contain a mythic substrate that probes at the poetic process, limitation of languages and the correspondence between inner existence and objective reality. So these are the famous style she followed. Her poems have been translated in several languages, including Italian, Japanese and Russian. Along with Bernadine Kendley, she is the most featured poet in the Green Book of Poetry. a large eco-poetry anthology by Ebon Mosley, which was published by Harpen San Francisco in 1996 as Earth Poems, Poem from Around the World to Honor the Earth. So, her poem is considered one of the best among Bernard Kenley's work, that is the title, The Green Book of Poetry. It is about an eco-poetrical anthology which was published by Ebon Mosley. Her poem is considered as a very, very famous poem where Judith Wright's writing style was steeply inspired by the places in which she had stayed. Where she stayed? At New Zealand, New South Wales, the subtropical rainforest of Tamborine Mountain, that is a Queensland, and the plains of the southern highlands near Braidwood. For Wright, her mission was to connect the human experience with the natural world through poetry and other works. So only she wrote many works regarding the nature, regarding the theme of the nature. Only the nature point, like animals, birds and whatever may be, she started to write about the nature in her works. It is a great style of Judith Wright. And she have a faith, that is, she have a faith and hope in land played and where land played an important and influential role for Judith Wright all her life. She have a hope on environment. This can widely be seen in her poetry, in which she takes effort to bridge the gap between a nature and man. Wright condemned the educational system and blamed it for failing to teach the students the art and pleasure of poetry. On her part, she popularized poetry by promoting students to read and write poems in school. However, she also expressed the uncertainty of poetry changing the schemes of things. For example, if the students have started to write poems when they were in school days, usually they used to write about a house, nature, animal, like that only they used to start the poetic style. So with that they can improve it. And she awarded many awards, that is in 1950, 1964, 1977, 1984, 1992 and 1994. 1950 Grace Lewin Prize and 1964 Australian Britannica Award, 1977 Robert Frost Memorial Award, 1984 Australian World Prize and 1992 Queen's Gold Medal for Poetry, 1994 Human Rights and Equal Opportunity Commission Poetry Award for Collected Poems. These are the famous award which was brought, which was awarded by Judith Wright. And when we see her works, that is when we see her works, she has written poetry, literary criticism and letters and so on. So we'll see the poetry. 1946 to 1993, she had a big collection of poetry. That is The Moving Image, Woman to Man, The Gateway, The Two Fires, Australian Bird Poems, Birds Poems, 5 Cents Selected Poems and Tantalus, The Half, The Other Half, The Attribute to Those Lovely Things, City Sunrise, The Other Half, Alive Poems, Fourth Quarter and Other Poems, Train Journey, Phantom Dwelling, A Human Pattern, The Flame Tree. So these are the famous poem which was poem collection and poem which was written by Judith Wright. She is well versed to write about the nature because she want to connect the nature to the man. It is a theme, that is, she want to combine them. And when we take a literary criticism, in 1955, William Bellbridge and The Modern Problem, that is a Canberra University College, and 1963 Charles Harpo, and 1965 A Preoccupation in Australian Poetry, 1967 Henry Lawson, 1971 Collected Poems, 1975 because I was invited, and 1991 going on talking. So these are the famous literary criticism which was written by Judith Wright. So Judith Wright is not only a poet, and she is a bell critic too. So we can see how many, that is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Seven famous literary criticism which was written by Judith Wright. When we take other works, that is a 1959, The Generation of Men, 1977, The Coral Battleground, 1981, The Cry of the Dead, 1985, We Call for the Treaty, 1991, Born of the Conquerors, that is a selected essay, 2001, After Time, that is a text. After Judith Wright died only, they have published this. After Time, it is a famous work of Judith Wright. And these are the famous works which was written by Judith Wright. But not only a short story, not only a poem and a literary criticism. She wrote the letters. She wrote the letters. The famous letters which was written by Judith Wright is from 2004 to 2007. That is the Equal Heart and Mind letters between a Judith Wright and Jack McKinney. 2006 with Love and Fury, selected letters of Judith Wright. And on 2007, Portrait of a Friendship, the letters of Barbara Bickerman and Judith Wright. So now Judith Wright is a poet and a literary critic, and she wrote some letters too. That is a prose. She is also a prose writer. When we take that from 2004 to 2007, her letter were published. During she started to lose her hearing in her mid 20s, and she became completely deaf by 1992. But on 26th June 2000, Wright died of heart attack in Canberra. At the time, she was 85 years old. Her ashes were scattered around the cemetery of Tambourine Mountain because she loves that place. Her possession of a strip of rainforest was donated to the state government so it could be preserved as a national park. It is one of the famous places in the Australia. Till now, they are having this as a national park. If you like this video, kindly subscribe to my channel and comment me. Kindly, if you want any notes, kindly ask me. Sure, I will upload it and give your support to me. Thank you.